Sarah Beth Levine is the namesake of the fifth and newest Sarah Beth's restaurant here in Tokyo, next to Tokyo Station, next to the Daimaru Department Store, and also just next to the Shangri-La Hotel. I hope that kind of puts it in perspective. And our very special guest, once again, the namesake for the restaurant, Sarah Beth herself. How you doing, Sarah Beth?
Fantastic.
Welcome back to Japan.
Oh, thank you.
And congratulations on your fifth restaurant.
This one is so fantastic.
And it's in a great location.
And the location is unbelievable.
Yeah.
Did you see the grass going up the side of the building?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the land and the windmills outside and the wind-powered electricity for the lights around the building?
WDI is taking great
care
of me.
No, I don't think they took care of me. It's the building.
It's the building.
It's the people who own the building who built the building.
They took care of that.
Oh, yeah.
And you're in a skyscraper area right now. Every building around here is a skyscraper.
It feels like New York. I don't mean that in a bad way. I just mean I feel like I don't feel Tokyo. It's funny. But when I walked down the street, I went a few blocks down the street from here, and all of a sudden, I felt my beloved Tokyo.
The fifth restaurant. That means you must be doing something right.
I hope so.
You're still famous for your Eggs Benedict?
Oh, I hope they'll forget about those a little bit.
Why?
We have so much else to offer.
For example, what?
Everything from small plates to large plates to dinner, real dinner, like we have at Shinagawa, but even a little bit more, a little bit different.
So tell us what's new on the menu here at Sarah Beth's.
Well, there's a particular dish on the menu that I'm really pleased with. And that's the crispy eggplant with the basil yogurt dip.
Mm.
We take the eggplant and we slice it very thin. And wherever the seeds were, after you dip it into the flour and then the special panko,
right.
And then you have a little bit of herbs or whatever, and you fry it, it creates like a little lace-like opening where the seeds of the eggplant were. And they're just beautiful, and they're just crunchy, and they taste so good. I mean, one serving isn't enough. I almost think that we need to make a bigger serving.
Again, what is this called?
This is called the crispy eggplant with basil yogurt.
Okay.
The other thing that I think is pretty terrific, and we've done before, is the scallop Benedict with bacon and quail egg. That's really, really nice with a little with the hollandaise on the bottom and the scallop on a little piece of English muffin, a thinly sliced, piece, and then comes the scallop, and then the little quail egg, and it has like a little beautiful little bamboo toothpick on the top, and little greens around it. There's two of them preserving.
And you made this especially for Japan, right?
Yes.
Using the uzura, the quail egg.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
And then
really
what I
tasty.
Love is this roasted carrot with the pine nut dip, which is also another small plate, and the Brussels sprouts and broccoli with the lime vinaigrette. That's, it's not too much. It's not too small. You can share. I'm hoping that our customers will come in and order four or five of them and then share some main dishes.
It sounds like a great way to spend a spring evening here in
yes,
Tokyo.
Yes, and upstairs or downstairs, wherever. Yeah. And we have a nice wine list here, and we have a full bar, and we have this very special coffee. And then, of course, we have a new soup here, which is a carrot ginger soup, and it has really nice frizzled, meaning just throw the ginger, a little shredded ginger, into the fryolator really fast. Just give it a little frizzle.
Carrot ginger soup.
And it has oranges and matchstick radish. That's a very nice little garni for the top of the carrot soup.
Now, do you develop all of these in your restaurant
in New York? I have a chef that I work with, and we work on all these things together. She's pretty special. Her name is Anne Rosenzweig.
We just met her a few minutes ago.
And you just met her. She's pretty special.
She seems to be taking care of a lot of the menu items here.
Well, she's very big with the savory. I'm still the sweets and breakfast girl, and Anne gets to the serious part of our menu, and she's really been fantastic.
Before we go any further, I have a couple of more big questions to ask you.
You didn't let me get to the large plates with the mussels.
Okay.
And the roasted salmon and the roasted chicken.
Excuse me, slow down.
Steak with the herb French fries. I mean, some nice dishes here.
What about the burgers? I remember you were very proud of your burgers.
The burger we have during the day. We do not have the burger at night.
Okay.
But instead at night we have the skirt steak, and we have the grilled pork and beans with the Chinese cabbage, which we've done that in Shinagawa. We brought that over here. It's really nice.
I tried the skirt steak the other night, and there was mushrooms on the side and some special sauce. What was that sauce?
That's the caramelized onions. You like
that? Oh, yeah. Caramelized onions. That made it.
Oh, good.
Absolutely made it. The fries were nice and crispy. Did we have your original ketchup on there? Because it seems to
no.
me...
No.
You made your own...
I don't think we have it. Wait, let me look
sauce?
And see again. I don't think we have it.
Do I remember that?
I'm going to have to go down and ask.
Well, the restaurant
I mean,
is
we
just
have it
open
in all the,
one
we,
day.
We have it in the other restaurant. We have it over at Shinagawa.
Yeah, I know.
And wherever we have the burger, it's the Plum.
Sarah Beth, you have a new cookbook out.
My new book.
What's special about this book?
Well, it's called Sarah Beth's Good Morning Cookbook. And it's breakfast, brunch, and baking. And it has a lot of the recipes that I've served in the restaurant over the years. And it was funny. I thought there were so many when I was doing the book. And I said, oh, I've got to do the potato waffle. Yes, and I'm going to tell them how to make gravlax. And yes, they have to learn how to make salmon rillette. And oh, I've got to do those special Swedish kind of crackers that I do, which are all grain and they're such a chew to them. And they'll be great with the... And then I realized, wait a minute. These were things that I would make and maybe run as a special, or maybe if I had somebody for dinner, I was making at home. And I realized that out of the 120 or 115 recipes, really only 15 of them, or 20, not even, were from the restaurant. They were all my own creations, and you know, things like pork slider in the morning and with
pork
my
slider.
Cherry plum ketchup, the crab cake, which I realized that over the years our chefs have kind of put their own little twist on the crab cake, and I was able to bring you the original crab cake, which is really interesting. This is sort of an aside, but you know, to go back to the original recipes, which are in my books that I keep, my own little books and in the bakery, and my own savory recipes over the years, it's very interesting how over the years things can be changed and you don't quite notice it. And then you make the original and you go, oh, wow, no wonder I love this so much, right?
Evolution
so
or de-evolution.
Is, right, well, and sometimes the evolution is really good, but sometimes not so good.
I see.
So the tomato soup that's in the book, and I do give out the creamy, velvety cream of tomato soup, which we do serve here. It's the original. It's
and that's this, available here in the restaurant.
Well, yes, but... It's the same soup, but there's something about the original where maybe there's like a tablespoon less shallot, or there's a, you know, an extra half a teaspoon of salt, or whatever, or the way the roux is prepared to thicken the soup.
Uh-huh.
You know, chefs want to take shortcuts. They just throw the flour in the pot. The real chef cooks his flour in butter until the flour gets cooked so that the soup is really creamy and you don't feel any of the flour that's in it to thicken it. So that is my original tomato soup recipe, which is pretty fantastic.
Now, is this book for professional chefs or
no,
can a housewife...
For you.
You're for me?
Cook. Yes, you're going to have to cook every recipe in the book.
I'm going to have to get the
book. You know, you're going to do that. And you're going to bake. And I've got new muffins and drop scones. And my lemon cake is there. And what do you call it? I have this one fabulous... Don't mind me. My eyes are closed.
That's okay.
I'm seeing the book. I have this one fabulous recipe that I make five things out of. I show you how to make a wonderful soft butter. It's a dough with a nice amount of butter, and it has a milk in it, so it's soft. And it makes, I use it, I punch out, like, I don't want to call it, it's not really a bagel, but I punch out bagel shaped small ones. And I put smoked fish on and capers on it, and it's really, really nice. You could serve it at a cocktail party. Forget breakfast or brunch. These are really, really nice. And that same dough, I make a coffee cake with it. I make sticky buns. I make a beautiful bread. And I make almost like a solen. I mean, it's just so versatile. That's like one recipe that you can make five things with. And probably, if you fooled around with it at home, you would make something else.
Now, can you prepare any of these things with a microwave?
Nope.
No. You need to have a real
yes.
oven and
yes.
gas or There's electric. You got to have the right stuff.
Microwave is for popping popcorn.
I see.
I don't like this microwave thing. I still haven't gotten down how to, and I have a very high-end microwave in my house.
I can imagine.
And it's only there because Bill.
Bill, your husband.
Has to have his microwave.
And what does he make with the microwave?
Well, because I work so much, I would say 4 to 5 nights a week, we either eat out or we order in. And the food is never hot enough for him when it arrives from the takeout. So he has to have the microwave to warm his food and, you know, totally changes the food.
It sounds like you're really excited about this new book. Give us the title and where can we get it?
It's called Sarah Beth's Good Morning Cookbook, Breakfast, Brunch, and Baking. We have a few copies here at the restaurant, at all the restaurants.
Oh, so it's not available in Japan except for at your restaurants.
And they can go on Amazon.
Oh, okay, sure.
And it's very reasonable.
Has it been translated into Japanese yet?
No.
Will that ever happen?
That would be really great.
Absolutely. Now, Sarah Beth, people are probably wondering about your background. How did you get started in this business?
How did I get started?
Yeah, how did you get started?
I mean, there wasn't really a plan.
Business?
I just was a really good cook at home, and I loved to bake, and my first mother-in-law taught me how to cook and bake, and I just loved doing it, and I think that I just accidentally fell into it. I mean, if you read my other book, you've read the introduction, the listeners probably don't know, but I began with a family recipe that for my orange apricot marmalade that I made in my home, and I made it for people, and they loved it, and somebody had a friend, and a friend had a friend who had a friend, and everybody talked about it, and I served it in a cafe that my husband had built for a client of his. He and his partner were builders, and I said to my husband, I said, maybe I'm going to make that marmalade for the opening, and he said, oh, that's a good idea, and the rest is history. People love the marmalade. I started to make it at home. I started to sell a few jars, and before you know it, I was in business. And then in business, I went from the marmalade to having to take it out of my house because I couldn't continue to make it there. It wasn't really, you know, it's not appropriate to cook from home and sell. And so that's how it all happened. We opened the first place, then we opened the second, and blah, blah, blah. And here we are now, what is this, number 15 or 16? I've lost count already.
Congratulations.
Soon to open in Dubai, and we'll be opening, yes, we just opened in Korea. And
what about Taiwan, Hawaii?
That's a possible on the horizon.
Okay.
We're working on that one now.
All right. What advice would you give to someone who would like to try to follow in your footsteps?
It's a lot different today to build a business like this. Now it takes money, a lot of money. Hmm. And when I started 35 years ago, we were able to take a small little storefront, and my husband renovated it. And what did we spend? $40,000 to open this most adorable little place you ever saw. That's how it started. Now it's a bigger undertaking, and it's harder in the restaurant world to survive. You need to have more tables and more seats because you need to do bigger numbers to pay the rents, and it's not so simple. So what I would tell people is, you know, if you want to do something like this, you really have to love it. You need to start small, and you have to really first go out and work the restaurant world and see if you really like this and you really want these hours and you want this standing on your feet all day and dealing with the public and always being cordial even when your feet hurt you and you're seating everybody at the table at night, you know, because that's how we all got started.
Sure.
You have to really be sure this is something you want to do. It's a big commitment.
Are you saying it's still possible?
I think it's still possible.
So if someone has...
Everything is possible. Your dream, everybody's dream is possible.
So the dream can come true.
Yes, it can.
Just like yours.
Yes.
Sarah Beth, once again, thank you very much for joining us here
My
on the
pleasure.
Kong Show. Congratulations on your fifth restaurant. We'll be fifth restaurant in Japan.
Yes.
As you said, you have 15 other restaurants about to open in Dubai.
I have to really count. Let's see, there's five freestanding, four Lord & Taylor is 9, one in Key West is 10, 5 here is 15, Korea
there you
is 16.
Go.
It's 16! We
16.
Just counted them.
That's amazing. You and Bill have built an empire, and it continues, and we wish you more success.
Oh, thank you so much.
And
it's always
best.
Wonderful to see you, and I hope every time I come, you'll come and find me.
I will. You can count on that.
Thank you so much.
Sarah Beth Levine, thank you for joining us.